Most people believe that childhood diabetes is directly linked to obesity or bad eating habits, but that simply is just not the case.
The US has the third largest confirmed cases of diabetes in the world.
So we thought it'd be helpful to ask people what they think about childhood diabetes. So we are here at Laguna Beach to ask them what they think. So what do you think is the leading cause for childhood diabetes?
I think it has to do with the poor nutrition and the excessive preservatives and additional chemicals that we put in our food supply.
Obesity, lack of education.
What they eat.
McDonald's.
Oh, definitely their diets of what's out there. What fast food and processed foods, what we're serving our kids.
Well, I definitely think it's because of diet and lack of exercise.
I guess uneducated habits of eating. I really don't know what's in our food now. And most things are unnatural and we don't understand what the ingredients are.
Parents not really caring about what their kids eat and just doing the easy thing and getting them food as quick as possible.
I think that diabetes maybe is like your health, like the food that you eat, like if you eat like a lot of like cake and like sugar and stuff, that'll that'll give you diabetes, I think.
Fast food.
Not working out.
McDonald's, all the junk food. All the junk food, yeah.
All those pastries, sweets, and stuff like that.
Well, it's probably an increasing problem due to the fact that so many kids are playing video games, spend so much time sitting on couches, and then not working off the sugar that they do intake through their, I do a lot of exercise, so it's not the fact that they're eating the sugars, it's the fact they're not doing anything to burn it off, and then these sugars are turning into fats and doing havoc on their inner system, so.
They need to do more of this, more exercise, instead of doing this.
Hi, my name is Annette Ramirez. I do pediatric nursing for close to 20 years, and today I'm being interviewed regarding juvenile diabetes. Juvenile diabetes could range from birth to usually 15 years. That's when we put you in the juvenile category. The most predisposing factor would be genetic and autoimmune disease. No, obesity is not directly linked to juvenile diabetes, but it is. It can be a trigger, usually after 15 years, if they do not take care of themselves with diet and exercise and taking care of their body.
1.6 million new cases of diabetes are diagnosed each year.
Diabetes is the seventh leading cause of death in the United States.
I think type 1 is juvenile. Diabetes, and you contract it, you get it early on in childhood. Second, type 2 is in adulthood. Yes.
I think type 1 is more hereditary. Type 2 is like an onset of a poor diet.
Type 2 is acquired, and type 1, I think, well, type 1 is kind of the parents' fault, right?
Yes. Type 1, you're born with. Type 2, you acquire from diet.
I know one's juvenile onset, one is more, and that's generally hereditary, and one is more diet environmental, and it's later in life.
Couldn't have said it any better.
I think type 1, either like you're born with it, and you get it just by, I don't know, still not eating right, but then type 2 is just like way too much sugar.
I think type 1, if I... not mistaken, is lower risk, and you can treat it with once a month or once a day. And the type 2 is a little bit more difficult to treat, and it leads to a higher risks.
Absolutely. I have type 2 diabetes.
Can you tell us what you know about type 1 or type 2?
Well, type 2 is, for me, it's my blood sugar is high, so I have to watch my diet. And stop eating processed foods and sugar and stuff like that. Type 1, I think I'm not really familiar with type 1. I think you're more, not born with it, but it's, I don't know the exact about type 1, to tell you the truth.
Do you guys know the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes?
Not really.
One is worse than the other one, I know that, but I don't know which one.
Yeah, for sure. Type 1, I think, is what you get like when you eat like too much food. Like your type 1 is like your health, I think. It has to do with like how much you eat, like the bad food you eat, and type 2 is like hereditary. Yeah.
How kids are affected by type 1 diabetes, usually in the beginning, we do not know that the kids do have juvenile diabetes because they can't talk. The symptoms will be increased thirst, lethargic, very hungry, weight loss. And when they get a little bit older, then we could usually see the factors of them just losing a lot of weight, a lot of hunger, wanting sweets, and just not feeling well. Insulin is a hormone, and it's made through the pancreas. If we do not have our pancreas working like it's supposed to be, what will happen is the sugar will stay in the bloodstream and not get it to the vital organs. And so the vital organs will go ahead and eat off itself. The body will go ahead and start digesting through the muscles and the organs, and that's how we lose weight. Then this sugar will stay in the bloodstream and not that way, and then that's how our blood sugars go up high. And that's when you get the symptoms of increased thirst, blurry vision, and it could also ruin your kidneys due to our kidneys filter the blood, and it has to work extra hard to get the sugar out of our blood.
Between 2001 and 2009, the prevalence of type 1 diabetes grew by 23%.
For children under 14, type 1 diabetes is estimated to increase by 3% annually.
Each year, more than 15,000 children and 15,000 adults, which comes to about 80 people a day, are diagnosed with type 1 diabetes.
Do you think childhood diabetes is a decreasing problem or an increasing problem?
Definitely increasing, absolutely.
Oh, definitely increasing, definitely.
Increasing.
Definitely an increasing problem.
I think it's decreasing because I think that the government is like giving us good healthcare and like medicine and stuff, and I think that I'm pretty sure you can cure it pretty quick these days. Yeah.
Definitely increasing. Increasing.
Increasing.
I believe it's still increasing.
An increasing problem.
It's definitely becoming more of a problem, but I think people are also becoming more aware of it, so that it might get better in the future.
Obesity is not directly linked to juvenile diabetes. It is genetic, and it is triggered by environmental settings.
As you can see, many people have the misconception that obesity is linked to childhood diabetes. But according to scientific studies, type 1 diabetes, which is found in children, is not directly linked to bad eating habits.